Earlier today, I uploaded a video talking about the Trello board and all of the fixes that were scheduled, but we didn't really know when. Thankfully, the team at Sledgehammer Games just released some official patch notes, and this patch is coming very soon. Tonight, in fact. Lots of goodies in here, including some questionable things, and we're going to talk about that here in this video today. So first things first, the update itself will contain a ton of bug fixes, like issues with that dev error that keeps popping up if you decide to use Daniel's alternative skin. It shouldn't crash the game anymore. Hopefully it doesn't, but it shouldn't crash the game anymore. Our seasonal challenges are going to be appearing as normal and track in Vanguard. We're going to be able to finally see those calling cards instead of having to hop over to Warzone and see what we need to do and then go back to Vanguard and complete it. The problem is these seasonal challenges weren't tracking in Warzone either, but thankfully after the update that comes through for Warzone, we should see those tracking properly. Here's a big batch of bug fixes that you can expect to find with the update tonight in Vanguard. Riot shields will now block front-facing damage and bullets won't penetrate the shield. There have been some changes to blueprints, including the firefight blueprint to remove active light coming from the front end of the barrel and parts of the optic. The Kar 98 Hunter is not going to allow you to aim down the iron sights when there's clearly an attached scope to it. The top break muzzles will no longer jump on reload. They've corrected loadouts using 7-round mags, so the total ammo count is divisible by 7. They've addressed multiple issues with charms in a quality of life pass. And finally, weapon animations have been polished and some glitches have been resolved. I'm guessing this last one here is talking more about specific reload animations and how sometimes your character's hand would go through the weapon in certain cases. Sometimes your thumb or your hand would be through the grip with certain attachments. So this was a pretty big issue if you are a stickler for the details. So hopefully that's being fixed and that's what they're referring to here because they don't go too far into detail. This next change actually has me very excited. We discussed the Panzerfaust challenge just a little bit earlier today, and I had mentioned how it's nearly impossible to take out UAVs and counter UAVs. I say nearly impossible because it is a thing that you can do, it's just not gonna happen most of the time. The Panzerfaust can't actually shoot that far, and you have to be on specific maps and specific areas where the UAV will cross in order for you to take it out with the missile. The good news is, this challenge is being changed completely. So after the update tonight, you won't have to destroy aerial streaks anymore. It's actually just going to be changed to long shot kills. The funny thing is, while I was playing this game right here and using the Panzerfaust, I kept thinking to myself, why don't they just change it to long shot kills? Because I kept doing it over and over again. So thankfully, they're actually going to be doing that. And it makes me very happy and excited to actually do these challenges. Next up, we're going to be seeing a change to the Kar 98K and the Type 99. When using a lower caliber magazine, these weapons will now retain the ability for one-shot kills when landing chest shots. This is important because the Kar 98 is already really powerful, right? But using those lower caliber magazines and gaining that additional movement speed, it was beneficial, but not to those who are playing core modes. It was hit marker city for both of these weapons, so seeing this change is actually quite great. Especially because I still need to work on those two rifles, which is awesome. Next up, we have the top break. It simply says no longer reduces damage, but range reduction increased. The top break is one of those really annoying weapons, and I know now that it's going to be much better with attachments, but that's one that I still need to work on myself. The PTRS is going to be getting a change. The default scope will no longer heavily obscure player vision when meleeing with a bayonet. Just as a reminder for those of you that never did that, this is what it looks like when you melee with the PTRS that has a default scope and a bayonet. I could see why they're changing this. It's definitely a way to give yourself a black eye over and over and over again. I could see why using a bayonet on this and having that default scope on there would be annoying. After that happened like a couple dozen times, I probably would switch over to the red dot. But thankfully, you won't have to worry about that. I'm not sure how they're going to change this. I'm not sure if they're going to just change the way that the bayonet action works or if they're just going to move the position of the scope. I'm not really sure. While we're on the topic of the bayonet, there's actually going to be a change made to the melee range. It's actually being reduced. So it's only going to be reduced when you have the bayonet attach and reach on. Of course, we've made a video about that. We talked about it towards the beginning of this game's life. We talked about how Commando Lunge returned, and it was pretty much just like the old days in Modern Warfare 2. I would imagine that the range is probably going to be cut somewhere in half, because right now it is quite ridiculous. But I can say I had some fun while it lasted. Tonight's update will also fix those camouflage challenges for the M1 Garand and the STG-44. These have been broken for a little bit over a month at this point, which sucks, but I'm glad that they're finally going to be fixed for everybody. Some people already had them fixed with an update that went out last night, but this didn't work for everybody. The double barrel is also going to be given the correct wording for the Death Artist challenge. Instead of 12 gauge mag, it should say 16 gauge mag. And even before this update, if you use the 16 gauge mag, it would work properly. We're going to see a small update tonight with cross progression as well. Master Ribbon data from Cold War will now be imported and reflected in Vanguard. We're going to be able to see that alongside everything that we're doing in this game currently with our prestige and our seasons. Here's something that really has me scratching my head though. This update is actually going to include a buff for the Mortar Barrage. They're increasing the damage dealt by the Mortar Barrage Flare. That initial disc that you throw down on the ground, that flare can actually damage players, and it's going to do more damage now. The second half of this buff is actually part of the placement of that flare. Apparently, it's been tweaked to allow deployment less difficult, which is going to be good for players who like to use that, but unfortunate for those who hate this particular streak. I sincerely hope that they end up nerfing this thing in the future, not necessarily from damage or the amount of damage the flare can do, but from the amount of time it lasts. Like, it's on the objectives for a very long time, and it just makes the screen shake all the time, and you can have multiple up at any given time. It's just really annoying, and it's something that I think a lot of players don't like. Next up, we have map fixes, and thankfully, these map fixes include out-of-map exploits. So on Paradise, our brand new map, they're going to be fixing several out-of-map exploits and instances of unnatural hitching when jumping against ramped walls. On Radar, they're also doing the same, fixing out-of-map issues and exploits, out-of-map spawns, and fixing issues which made some doors indestructible. I had this happen too, and I thought it was kind of weird that I shot a Panzerfaust at it and it did not explode. That was really strange. On Desert Siege, they're going to be changing up the spawns to reduce instances of spawning close to enemies. They're fixing a rendering issue that resulted in super intense fog for some players. I've seen this happen a couple of times. It makes the map unplayable. I've also had that happen on Subpen, which was really weird. Blinking texture issues have been fixed in several locations as well. In Bocage, bullet penetration issues for certain walls have been fixed, and Mark II frag grenade's blast radius no longer affects players who should be protected by walls. This was a big issue on that map, and I know I got a lot of triple kills when I shouldn't have. On Red Star, they're fixing a bug that resulted in lighting effects following a player, like a spotlight around the map. On Berlin, distracting and graphically incorrect shadows no longer appear under light fixtures. In Numa Numa, they removed invisible geometry that blocked bullets in midair. In Gavutu, they fixed an issue in which an invisible wall remained after it was destroyed. In Demyansk, demolition and tactician perks now operate as intended. And then finally, in Subpens, Castle, Oasis, and Das Haus, they fixed out-of-map exploits. Champion Hill's getting some updates. Players will no longer crash out of Champion Hill duos, resulting in the closure of the entire game, and players will now be able to access the scoreboard and spectate mode. The thing is, too, like, they even updated the campaign. They fixed a progression blocker in the Lady Nightingale level caused by an unresponsive character. I had this happen, and I know exactly the spot they're talking about. It's in the sniper portion where you're climbing the building and you need to actually kill all of the tanks, if you will, those pretty heavy guys, and one of the tanks will like fall out of the map geometry or just not appear and just run away from the battle, and you'll never be able to complete that. You have to restart over and over and over again until he finally pops up. So that's pretty cool. But that is pretty much everything I want to talk about. This update should be coming out fairly soon, like within the next 30 minutes or so, depending on when this video gets uploaded. I appreciate y'all coming out to this video here today. Drop a like on it if you enjoyed, subscribe for more awesome videos, and if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch you later, guys. Peace!